and welcome to the graduation ceremony for Keene High School's class of 2022. My name's Cindy Gallagher, and I'm the high school principal. We've worked very hard this year to bring back a number of traditions and celebrations, the first of which is a very soft welcome by the faculty for the graduates. But now I would like to ask the graduates to stand and welcome the faculty and the staff and the leadership team for Keene School District, led in by Superintendent Robert Millay and Keene Board Chair George Downing. Please welcome our staff. No, you guys are going that. No, you're right. You're right. Jacqueline, you're right. There you go. Everybody's going that way. Sorry. Miss Taft and Miss Perry, you're coming up here. Thank you. Graduates, you may be seated. I'm pleased to introduce Haley Barnum, who will begin our ceremony.
Good evening. I'm Haley Barnum, the class of 2022 secretary. I would ask you all to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. After the pledge, I would ask that you stay standing for the Star Spangled Banner presented by the Keene High School Vocal Jazz Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Matthew Lease. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars
oh, so Thank you, Dr. Lease and Vocal Jazz. Hello, family, friends, and graduates. My name is Mia Brown, and I have had the pleasure to serve as the Class of 2022 Vice President. I will be leading you through today's commencement celebration. Thank you all for being here to support and celebrate the Keene High School graduating Class of 2022. And without further ado, I would like to recognize Mr. George Downing, the Keene School Board Chair.
Good evening. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome you all to this evening's commencement ceremony. I am particularly pleased to welcome you back after 2 years to this field and this stage for our full traditional ceremony. The class of 2022 is the third graduating class to have had your school year significantly disrupted by the pandemic. You had 1 year of what we are now referring to as normal school, followed by 3 years of varying levels of disruption and confusion. Through it all, you have met every change and every challenge with grace, with humor, with strength, and above all, with compassion for one another. This year, you were asked to do something no previous class has had to do. As the high school returned to normal, whatever that means now, you were tasked with helping remember, recreate, and reinvent all of the activities and ceremonies that represent a senior year. You, the class of 2022, have helped bring back homecoming, concerts, sporting events, celebrations, prom, and finally all of the activities of this past week, culminating in this commencement ceremony. Your spirit shines through everything the school has accomplished this year, and we thank you. On behalf of the Keene Board of Education, the SAU 29 School Board, and the school boards of all the towns contributing to the success of this class, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate the Keene High School class of 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Downing, for your words of wisdom. Now it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Cindy Gallagher, the principal of Keene High School.
It's hard to imagine that we're celebrating the class of 2022 this evening. In many ways, the year raced by far too quickly. I'm sure that we're all grateful, though, to be here with such gorgeous weather. I've also been asked to be aware that the Celtics play at 9, and I'm supposed to find out how many of you think they're going to get it done in 5, how many think it's going to be 6, does anybody think they're going to lose? Just checking, okay. Parents and guardians, you worked hard, your hard work has paid off, and I'd like to thank you for all of your support that you gave your student to get them here today. Seniors, please join me in thanking your parents and guardians. I know we recognized them and applauded when they came in, but seniors, I'd like you to also, one more time, thank the dedicated faculty and staff who have helped you make it through for the 4 years here. It's always hard at the end of a year to find out who's retiring. We have a number of folks who are retiring, and I want us to think about this. Some of them went to school here and have been here for almost 40 years. If there's 300 kids in a class, 40 times 300, 1,200? That's a lot of single students. All right, I'd like us to recognize first our retiring teachers, Mrs. Barnes, Mrs. Herbert, Mrs. Kissel, and Ms. Robarge. Thank you for your dedication. I'd also like to acknowledge that in addition to dedicated teachers, we have very dedicated staff with longevity. This year retiring is Mrs. Gallagher. I read my name and stopped. Deb Gallagher from Athletics, and Mr. Maynard from our custodial staff. Let's thank them as well. Seniors, Yesterday at the Salmagundi Assembly, you were identified, again, as the last class with a normal year and the first class to bring back our traditions and celebrations. You're going to hear a theme here. I appreciate all that you accomplished this year, particularly that you were able to make the year more normal. I want to thank you for homecoming and your patience around the limited tickets for the dance. You were patient. I appreciate that. I want to thank you for the pep rallies. Thank you for the spirit weeks and the prom. You created a new tradition by having it here under the tent. That was a very nice prom. And finally, to the yearbook staff and to the seniors and to everybody that made yesterday special, thank you for Salmagundi. That was awesome. I'm grateful for the past few weeks where I've had an opportunity to learn so much more about you. In May, more than 100 of you participated in the Cheshire Career Center Completer Ceremony. That was a wonderful celebration, and that kicked off this very festive set. We were able to hear many stories about the outstanding qualities that you embody and the joy that the faculty share when they talk about you. Then a smaller group of you took a significant risk and told personal stories at baccalaureate. That was a very intimate, small group, but the stories you shared were inspiring. If you're looking for those, all of the live stream links will be published. The baccalaureate's worth seeing if you missed it. Between special student recognition and the senior scholarship last night, I heard even more stories about your accomplishments. I believe that every one of you has a unique and important story to share. If every one of you stood up here giving a speech this event, we'd hear stories about excellence in academics, music, drama, and dance. We'd hear stories about digging in and demonstrating an unyielding work ethic. Perhaps you're already working in a job. Hopefully it's something that you love. We would hear stories about athletic prowess and stories of students going on to serve our country in various military branches. I'd like to pause for a second. Will all of our students who are enlisted please stand to be recognized? Thank you for your service. But as I've talked about the positives, we also acknowledge that sometimes this is hard. We would also hear stories about how life was hard, it was unfair, and sometimes tragic. Throughout all the stories, you have two things in common tonight. You're members of the class of 2022, and you're all soon about to become Keene High School graduates. The beauty of graduation is that from here out, you become the full authors of your story. You have the ability, and more importantly, the responsibility to make your story meaningful. We're all here today, your family, your friends, the faculty and staff, to let you know that we're proud of you. We believe in you. We trust the choices that you're going to make. You've proven yourself at Keene High, and you're ready to write your next chapter. I wish you the very best of luck. Thank you, and enjoy the night.
Thank you, Dr. Gallagher, for recognizing our achievements. On behalf of the class of 2022, we wish you good luck as you continue at Keene High School. I will now introduce Isabella Georges, the president of the Keene High School class of 2022.
Well, before I get started, I want every one of my peers to take a good look around. First, let's congratulate all of us for being here together. We've truly put our all into these last 4 years. Second, look at everyone here who made it all possible, especially all of the teachers. They taught us so much. Lastly, look in the stands behind you at everyone here who loves you. All of the parents, grandparents, siblings, aunts, uncles, and the people at home who supported every your step. Graduates, everybody here right now is so proud of you. We should be proud of ourselves. In the fall, I will be going to the University of Connecticut to study business, real estate and urban economic studies to be specific. I would like to thank the scholarship committee, the Fuller Bartlett family, and the family of Mr. Harry Lickman for awarding me scholarships that will help lighten the financial burden of my higher education. Next, I would like to give a special thank you to Mr. John Lupa for not only being one of my favorite educators at Keene High School, but for also being a great mentor. I went into this school year planning on becoming an electrician after high school. See, graduates, it's really okay to not know what you want to do. Mr. Lupa sparked my interest in business, and I cannot wait to see where it will take me. It has been so much fun and so rewarding leading this class all 4 years. With how hectic it has been, nothing has been easy, and for that, I'd like to recognize the council for all that they have done and for the patience that they've had with me. I think when a lot of you think about what goes on in the council, you think of prom or the homecoming float or fundraising, but there is so much more that goes on behind the scenes. These class officers have put so much into making our time in high school as memorable as possible, and I think they did such an amazing job despite all of the special circumstances. Next, I'd like to thank Ms. Tracy Johnston and Mr. Bill Hope for being there every step of the way. You guys were great advisors and mentors overall. You are the kind, compassionate role models we needed. The question many of us have been asked relentlessly lately is, so what are you doing after you graduate? Or even worse, what do you want to be? Graduates, if you have a solid response and claim to know exactly what you're going to be when you grow up, you're lying. And you know what? That's good. I think that in having this uncertainty, you are much more able to be receptive to new perspectives and experiences. This way you can try new things, and then when you're ready, you can find your calling and then do the big scary adult things. Right now, let's take a second to stop thinking about the next steps and take a moment to take a step back and acknowledge all the hard work and achievements that have been made. We have graduates going to Ivy League schools, there's graduates going to trade school or the military or doing this or that, and those who have no idea what's next. And you know what? What you do after this does not matter to me. What matters is how you do it. Whether you're on your chosen path or searching for it, treat everyone with respect and kindness. It really does make a difference. Be the most authentic version of yourself and do it unapologetically. And never let your resilience die. It took me a long time to think about what to say in this part of the speech. It came to me last Saturday. I spent most of that day procrastinating writing this and instead decorating my mortarboard. That evening, I went out with my dear friend Katie Bauer for Chinese food. At the end of the meal, after we got all up to date on the latest KHF gossip, I opened my fortune. It read, "Do not step on others to get to the top." And that is what I'd like my last word of advice to you all to be. Everyone has their own interpretation of what success is. Your success should not be measured by how much is in your wallet or how many likes you get on social media. You shouldn't seek validation in comparing yourself to others, and you shouldn't be uplifting yourself on the premises of others' weaknesses. You should strive to achieve your personal definition of success, and you deserve to be happy. The scholars, artists, athletes, advocates, and allies who make up the class of 2022 are a resilient group who are so very capable of changing the world. I started creating this speech in my head during a lockdown drill we had just 2 Wednesdays ago. In Keene High School, and almost all schools in America these days, during a lockdown drill, you are supposed to replicate what you would do in the event of some kind of danger that we are told does not include an active shooter. This drill took place only days after the tragic shooting in Uvalde, Texas, that took the lives of 19 students and 2 teachers. As I sat silently in lockdown, I kept thinking about how since Columbine, according to the Washington Post, more than 311,000 students have been at school during some form of gun violence. Something needs to be done. It's time we raise our voices. This has become almost normal in our society, and this concerns me. So graduates, please get out there and advocate for change and vote. We need to make a change for the sake of our children. We live in a world where you have to teach children and teenagers what to do in unthinkable situations like Sandy Hook, Parkland, or Virginia Tech before they can read. Doing this drill so close to Uvalde was nerve-wracking. As I sat in silence in the corner of my Advanced World Cultures classroom with all of my peers, I kept thinking about the word lockdown and how it has been really prevalent throughout our high school experience. When you look in the Merriam-Webster dictionary, some of the first known uses of the word lockdown were in 1973, and it was in reference to prison or jail. I feel like many of us have or heard peers refer to high school as feeling like prison. Especially with teachers on hall duty acting like prison guards, there are many students who feel locked up. However, we all recognize that school is not prison and that we are lucky to have teachers who have stepped up to help with our challenging circumstances. But to the students who most feel like school is prison, I want to personally say I'm proud. School isn't easy academically, emotionally, or mentally. And to these students, I'd like to congratulate you on not giving up and persevering to get through to walk across this stage today. You made it. The other meaning of lockdown I thought about has to do with that thing that changed our lives forever back in 2020. I told myself I wouldn't talk about COVID, but you can't really talk about our high school experience without it. The pandemic forced us to help those in need, and it really proved how adaptable we are. Lockdown showed us that we really do need to appreciate every moment and do the things that you yearn to. After all, in the blink of an eye, you can be left unable to do the things you love most. Because of the virus, we experienced not just hybrid and remote learning, but staff shortages and classes that were left frequently without a teacher for days at a time. I feel that some students have been left socially stunted and aren't sure how to conduct themselves both within the school and out in the world. This has left KHS quite turbulent. With the help of the campaign KHS Together and the strong supportive community that is the class of 2022, I think as students we have shown that we can come together and make a difference. We have also been role models for younger students. It can be easy to get lost in the chaos of life, but we must remember to slow down and work together and uplift each other, giving a hand to those who need it most. We are the generation of both hope and change. We are entering the next phase of lockdown. We have a lot of responsibilities ahead of us. We are living on a planet that is dying at the will of capitalism. We are fighting against gun violence. We face the loss of body autonomy. We are still dismantling white supremacy. War and hunger persist across the globe. Here in the States, we are censoring learning about race and the LGBTQ community. Ultimately, we will be the ones to create solutions for these daunting issues. I knew this class and this generation as a whole were world changers in 2020. As a Black woman, it was both strange and difficult growing up in Keene, New Hampshire. After the murders of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, I was devastated. But I was able to see many of my peers protest and advocate for justice in ways I've never seen them do before. For the first time in my life, I saw my peers rallying in the streets, exercising their rights to free speech and peaceful protest. It was honestly surprising and refreshing to see everyone do more than just repost things onto their Instagram stories. We must continue to raise our voices. I know that what I have said today may have made you uncomfortable or even upset. We must feel these difficult emotions. How are we supposed to tackle these problems without first addressing them? It's risky and scary to be up here, vulnerable and raw. However, I feel a sense of responsibility and pride almost. I feel that these topics I've covered today are not only real, but substantial. I feel that it is my responsibility to use this platform for change. These changes will not only improve the lives of this generation, but also the generations to come. Our rights, justice, and freedoms are in lockdown. We need to continue to work together to get out of these lockdowns. This should be our mission, graduates. We are the ones left to put the broken pieces back together. Although there is improvement to be made, I am confident that the class of 2022 is highly capable of making it. We must work together and not give up. Graduates, keep speaking up for the sake of yourselves, the ones you love, the world, and the society we belong to. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Izzy, for your message and for all that you've done for the senior class. At this time, I would like to welcome Superintendent Robert Millay.
Thank you, Mia, and thank you, Izzy, for your very articulate and insightful thoughts. Truly appreciate it. Another round of applause, please. Typically, the beauty of going last is that you get to say all of the things that others before you haven't said. But in this case, I don't know that there's a lot that has been left unsaid. And there's not a lot more that I'm going to be able to add to that. I do want to pause for a quick second and say thank you to Allie Manwaring for putting the requisition in a little earlier this year to provide for this wonderful weather so that we could avoid a blizzard bag graduation. In all seriousness, though, I do want to say thank you to a few folks. I want to start by saying thank you to the entire Keene High School team. It was a job well done. It may not have always been smooth and easy, but yet here we are celebrating the successes of all of those efforts. I want to thank the Keene Board of Education and all of the school boards that send their students to Keene High. All of your support and efforts have paid off as well. The work that you do allows us to do the work that we do for the students that will eventually sit where these students are sitting here tonight. I want to thank all of the parents, the guardians, and the members of the community who have and continue to withstand the tests of time. I also want to thank Project Graduation and all of the wonderful people that helped put that together to provide a safe, fun, and memorable graduation night for our students. And lastly, and most importantly, I want to say thank you to the class of 2022. You're the reason that we're here today. As I was thinking about what I wanted to share with all of you tonight that fully described the class of 2022, I went a little old school and picked up a good old-fashioned dictionary. Many of the words that came to mind as I was thumbing through the pages, such as amazing, bold, confident, enthusiastic, hopeful, kind, loving, optimistic. But when I got to the letter R, it was undeniably clear. Right here in the dictionary, under resilient, it clearly states the Keene High School class of 2022. We didn't choreograph that, did we, Izzy? On August 29th, 2018, the class of 2022 walked into Keene High School for their first day of school as high schoolers. Little did they know, or any of us know for that matter, what was in store for them. Yet through all of the adversity that was thrown their way, the class of 2022 refused to give up, to stop striving, or to just simply quit. Regardless if it was on stage, in the classroom, on the playing field or court, or if it was just out in the community, the class of 2022 repeatedly found ways to demonstrate their awesomeness. They have shown us the art of what Dag Hammarskjöld, the former Secretary General of the United Nations and Nobel Peace Prize winner, meant when he said, "Never measure the mountain or the height of the mountain until you reach the top." Tonight, you sit on top of what I'm confident is only one of many mountains you'll ascend. Now, 715 school days later, we have 305 Blackbirds sitting before us as outstanding young adults ready to go out and accomplish many more great moments. So with that, I'll leave you with the advice of Cody Johnson, who shared with us through song, "If you have a dream, chase it, because a dream won't chase you back." And when that dream becomes a reality, I hope you all enjoy the view from the top of the mountain. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Millay. We appreciate your support and encouragement. Now, I would like to introduce Mr. Justin Spencer of Chaos and Kindness, our guest speaker.
Good evening, everybody. Thanks for having me. I had the opportunity to come speak to this school a few years ago, one of the last assemblies we did before COVID took over the world. And I said a lot of swear words in that assembly. And they asked me not to do that tonight, so my speech has been cut in half. So this will be brief. I won't take up too much of your time. but I will make sure that my words are valuable. It's an honor to be here to speak not only for the students, but the individuals who are in the audience here tonight that have worked so hard. As a father of two daughters, I know the love that you share, the admiration, that you care so much about the individuals who are up here taking the next step in their journey. And I know what you feel. You probably feel more emotional. This means a lot more to you, maybe even to them. And for that, I recognize all the hard work you individuals have put in to the students who are graduating here tonight. Kids, I'm here to tell you, or young adults now. These individuals care about you a lot, and don't ever forget that. I've had the chance to meet a lot of you individuals that are graduating here today. Two of them are my employees at our Chaos and Kindness store. Quinn Wilson, Jason Foster. I met Jason when he was a little kid. At the time, I was living in Las Vegas, and I had an idea to put together the largest anti-bullying sign in world history. And to achieve it, I would need 220,000 kids. Well, Jason helped me lead the charge here in Keene when he was 10 years old, and made sure that all the students of the middle school and the elementary schools got together and were part of that. I've long had a relationship with this town. Although I didn't graduate from Keene, I've probably spent more time in this high school than I did my own. I have ADHD, shocker. I was never asked to speak at my high school graduation. Hell, I barely graduated. I was a D student, and I got a fourth grade English level, and it's gotten worse since then. And there's a lot of individuals in this crowd tonight. I see beards. I see athletes with beards, different skin colors, different sexual preferences, different dreams, different goals. Some people who've been labeled disabled. Some who've got, I was looking through the pamphlet, acronym after acronym, stating your achievements, the things that you've done, some with nothing. And I'm here to tell you, every single person here is equal. Every single person here is equal. A lot of you have overcome some serious trials and tribulations in your life. Some of you here today are barely making it. Some of you excelled. Some of you guys are star athletes, going to go to college, going to become millionaires. Some of you guys are going to find purpose in traveling the world, being homeless and hitchhiking. Some of you guys are getting straight A's. Some of you guys are skipping school and smoking pot. Let's be real. Again, we're all equal, and however we got here today, it's about you. I hear someone laughing in the back. Get them some snacks. But one thing I do want to say before I leave here today is it's important to find a purpose. It's one thing that I think is the most quintessential thing that you seek in your life above all else. You see, a life without purpose is an empty bank account. I can sit up here as a kid that grew up in a trailer park, a food stamp kid. I didn't have anything. I wasn't the star athlete. I wasn't the popular kid. I was bullied by other people. I can sit up here and tell you I've had all the success. I've been on the biggest TV shows. I've traveled the world. I've broken world records. If you don't have purpose, your life won't have happiness. And that should resonate from the individuals who are graduating here today to the generations above that are watching. Your happiness is not a metric by money, but your purpose that you wake up every day. And that purpose will change from time to time. Hell, for me, it changes on the hour. What is it that I want to do? You don't have to figure it out. But just make sure that you have a purpose at all times. At all times, you have a directive. I love what was said earlier about the importance of kindness. The catchphrase in our TV show is "In a world full of chaos, to show your kindness." That's one thing that doesn't cost us any money, and it's something that each and every one of us can do. And I say it, And I'll say it again. Everybody here is equal. I'm no more important than you, and you're no more important than me. And someday you're going to look back, and trust me, I know as I get older, my hair would be gray if I didn't dye it, if I wasn't insecure. The Botox is wearing off. It's been 3 weeks. The pants are getting tight because I refuse to change. And I can step here as an older gentleman with two kids, and I can tell you that I get approached all the time. Hey, man, I went to high school with you. And I'm like, I don't remember anything. And I remember I like what you said. It's not measured in likes in social media. It won't matter what John 3507 said about you. Follow your passion, follow your dreams. June 25th, Recycled Percussion will come back to Keene and will perform a show at the Colonial Theater. I reserved a ticket for you and any guests that you want to help. I've set aside $10,000 in tickets for the class of 2022 to be there for me, with me. If you don't come and it's free, I'm going to get really, really upset. I've had the opportunity to do several keynotes at different high schools. This one's probably the most meaningful, only because I have such a love affair with Keene. It's why we opened a store here. I've just spent a lot of time. Keene helped me shape the dreams that I have today. There was a time where I was driving a $400 Ford Escort that barely ran with bumper stickers, playing the Keene Pumpkin Fest for tips. Keene and everybody in this community, thank you for welcoming me and being a part of my legacy and my story. It's meant a lot. Before I go, I do want to give a scholarship. I do this every time I do a keynote. Hey, Jimmy, can you come up here for a second and help me with this one? Yeah. This is my friend Jimmy. Jimmy said to me, we were walking over from the car, and I said, Jimmy, he said, man, this brings back memories. I said, he's from New Jersey. I said, what memories does it bring back to you, Jimmy? He said, graduating high school. I said, what'd you do? He said, I threw my hat in the air. I said, did you like high school? He goes, eh. I go, did you get picked on, Jimmy? He goes, yeah. I go, people pick on you, Jimmy? He goes, yeah. Well, Jimmy has Williams syndrome, and I'll tell you right now, he's the most badass kid I know. All right? So, he never got an opportunity to make a speech, and it will be short. But I want to give a scholarship. I'm going to need your help, Jimmy, because I give a scholarship for $1,000 every time I do a keynote at a high school to the most complicated long name I can find in the booklet. This goes back to pure chance. Everybody in here deserves a scholarship of some kind. I can only afford to give one. And the most insecure thing you can do outside of eating spaghetti on a date is to try to read a name with a third grade English level that is spelled like this. And I'm about to botch the hell out of it. But the good news is you're getting $1,000 from me. All right, let's start. Let's see. We'll start. Jimmy, help me with it. What does it say? Come closer, buddy, so they can hear you.
Natasha?
No, not even close. You want me to do it? All right. Over 30 letters, dude. This is unbelievable. Naranja Thangam. Archer Naraj Indi Humathi. Did I get anything right? I don't have the money with me. You can go back to your seat. So take that $1,000. Do not spend it on school. Spend it on having some fun this summer. But thank you, guys. Congratulations to each and every one of you today. Enjoy your summer. Enjoy the years to come. Have fun. And Jimmy, why don't you close this one out?
I just want to say thank you guys for having us. And good luck with everything, a class 2022. And let's go!
Let's go! Congratulations, thank you so much for having us.
Thank you, Justin. We really appreciate your message and that you took the time to be with us at this ceremony. Now, I would like to introduce the Keene High School Vocal Jazz Ensemble, who will perform Take Me Home under the direction of Dr. Matthew Lease. Dr. Lease and Vocal Jazz. Now, I would like to introduce Ms. Caitlin Taft, an esteemed math teacher at Keene High School, for the presentation of the Achievement Award recognizing Keene High School's valedictorian.
Good evening. Hi, class of 2022. I'm so excited for you. Congratulations, I'm gonna miss you. Anyway, as Mia said, I'm Caitlin Taft, the proud mathematics teacher of Elizabeth Stanish. I had the pleasure of having Elizabeth in class all year, both in AP Calculus and AP Statistics, yeah. Whether it was first block or fourth block, she entered the room with a smile, brightening my day. I first met Elizabeth 15 years ago in my linear algebra class at Keene State College. She didn't ask a lot of questions back then, but she's come a long way. You might find it odd for such a young student to be in a college-level mathematics class, but that tells you something about Elizabeth. She was thirsty for knowledge right out of the gate. In truth, her mother Karen was the professor of the class, and Elizabeth would sometimes tag along. but it clearly set the stage for the future of Elizabeth Stanish. In her career at Keene High School, she earned a cumulative grade point average of 4.495. She earned, yes, very impressive. She earned an A+ in all but three courses where she earned an A. This is no small feat for any student, especially one that participated in the myriad of extracurricular activities that Elizabeth did. She has a deep passion for the performing arts and was a member of the KHS Drama Club, participating in every show since her freshman year. I remember seeing her as Mama Morton in Chicago in 2019, and I thought, whoa, this girl's got something special. And if you've seen her perform, you'd probably thought the same thing. She was an avid participant in MoCo dance and theater productions, dancing for 12 hours a week. She was a camp counselor at Cupcake Summer Camp and a member of the KHS a cappella choir the past 3 years and the leader of Amplitude this year. She also found the time to be the president of student council and a member of class council, a member of Interact all 4 years of high school, a member of the National Honor Society and its vice president this year, and a member of the National Art Honor Society since 2019. Her accomplishments did not go unnoticed, receiving a variety of awards and accolades throughout the past 4 years. She received the Excellence in English Award in 2019, 2020, and 2021. The Smith Book Award in 2021. She won a silver medal in Level 2 in Le Grand Concours, the National French Contest, a National Merit Scholar semifinalist, and won 2 silver keys in the Scholastic Art Awards. It's almost unbelievable that one student could accomplish so much throughout 4 years of high school. But that's Elizabeth. She is truly phenomenal. My favorite thing about her, besides her love of mathematics, is her disposition. Walking into class each day with a cheery greeting, Elizabeth was always happy to be at school. She is positive, proactive, and strives to make things better. When she sees something that needs improvement, she doesn't complain. Rather, she comes up with solutions and works to make them happen. Many times in class, she would speak with her peers, asking their opinions and brainstorming ideas to make Keene High School a better place. But it was a better place just by her being in it, inspiring others to take pride in their school and have the greatest time ever while they were here. Elizabeth lives life to the fullest and never lets an opportunity go to waste. As a student, she understands that mathematics is collaborative and classmates must work together to solve difficult problems. She's a true team player, valuing the opinions of others while offering her own thoughts on the best path to take. She sees problems in different ways and can often decipher the most efficient path to success quite quickly. She is a true mathematician, and I am so glad that I had the opportunity to spend as much time with her this year as I did. I thank her for her hard work and positive attitude. We will miss her at Keene High, but know she will go on to great success. Elizabeth will be attending Yale University in the fall to study what else? Mathematics. It is a great honor for me to welcome to the stage the Keene High School class of 2022 valedictorian Elizabeth Stanish.
Hello, graduating class of 2022. It feels surreal to finally be able to say that. Before I begin my hopefully inspirational speech to you all, I have a task for you. Turn to the person next to you. They, just like you, have accomplished a feat unique to our class. graduating high school in the most hectic 4 years possible. Introduce yourself to them if you don't already know them from standing in that really long line for half an hour, and congratulate them on making it here. We all deserve that celebration. Go ahead, congratulate them. To echo their words, congratulations. It seems like just yesterday we were standing outside meeting our advisors at freshman orientation, yet here we are sitting together about to graduate high school. We've certainly overcome countless obstacles to get here, from taking our first and only final exams freshman year to having our grading system changed not once, but every year since. Needless to say, we've also seen the pandemic flip our lives upside down several times. We know each other's Google account profile pictures just as well as each other's real faces. And we have mastered the art of using a Chromebook efficiently while in quarantine. Despite these and many other challenges, our class has also achieved many successes and built a community of leaders, activists, and friends. While COVID is one factor of our time at Keene High, our memories of winning the homecoming float contest for 4 years, becoming Division I state champions and all-stars, getting sunburnt on the famous flood field day, playing cornhole at prom a couple weeks ago, and so many more are even more important in defining our high school experience. Not to mention the countless classes launching rockets into the sky, debating minimum wage, discussing classic literature, and working through the infamous functions problem sets and imp portfolios. We are truly extraordinary in our ability to mesh essential high school experiences with the many challenges thrown our way. Our path to graduation wouldn't have been possible without countless people who interacted with us over these 4 years. To our teachers, thank you for helping us learn as students, develop new ideas and unique opinions, and become compassionate and independent individuals in the community. To the administration and staff, thank you for greeting us in our house offices every morning with a smile, and for keeping KHS running in the complete chaos of the last couple years. To our families, thank you for supporting us every step of the way at every game, late night study session, and performance. And finally, to each and every one of you, thank you for making our high school years so memorable and wonderful. Throughout our 4 years, our relationships with each other have only grown and strengthened despite our many hardships. Turn to that person you congratulated earlier and thank them for helping us all reach this point. Thanks, guys. Now, as we are about to each go our separate ways, I have three pieces of advice to you all to go with the whole hopefully inspirational speech thing. First, despite the obstacles we will all surely face, remember to treat others, but more importantly, treat yourself with kindness, respect, and compassion. In a world where it seems we receive more devastating news each day, and where the pressure to be perfect is exacerbated by social media, the importance of kindness has never been greater. I urge you to walk through life with the understanding that everyone deserves a gentle smile, compliment, or just a little help. Take time for yourself as well, since we must first be kind to ourselves before we have the strength to help others. We can and will be remembered for many things, but extending a kind hand to others will leave a far greater impact than any individual job or accomplishment. Second, rely on those around you and use others as your greatest resource. Throughout high school, our only consistency has been each other. We've supported each other in classrooms, audiences, and student sections. We felt more comfortable turning on our cameras online once one person showed their face. And we've been each other's strongest shoulders to lean on. Without each other, we would never have been able to block the parking spots on Tuesday, and our essays would lack the insight given through peer edits. Even Quinn in the hallways would be incomplete without other students to interview in the halls. As an individual, we can create a beautiful image of our life, but when we collaborate, we can turn those images into a mural of strengths and impact. Be open to collaboration and accept help from others with grace. You never know what picture they will help you create. My third and final piece to you is to live every day as your genuine self and never let anyone silence your impactful and ever louder voice. Each of us is poised with a unique story to change the world. And when we test our voices and tell those stories, we are unstoppable. We are the class that fights for fading traditions, organizes protests downtown, writes argumentative letters to state representatives, and works to change our local community for the better. We are powerful. As we leave high school, I implore you to continue building your stories, strengthening your voice, and fighting for whatever cause you believe in. To quote Meryl Streep, it's amazing what you can get if you quietly, clearly, and authoritatively demand it. Congratulations, class of 2022. We did it!
Congratulations, Elizabeth, on all that you've accomplished. I'm now pleased to introduce Mrs. Perry, an art teacher who will recognize the Keene High School salutatorian.
First of all, what an incredible point of view from up here to see you like this. Congratulations. As you heard, I'm Shannon Perry and I'm an art teacher here at Keene High School. I'm honored and humbled to be asked by this year's salutatorian to introduce her to you. She entered one of my rambunctious Art 1 classes as a sophomore. She was quiet, shy, all-around good student. She impressed me immediately, and I encouraged her to continue. Well, I might have begged a little. She soon grew into an independent, articulate individual, well-respected for her artistic voice and point of view in AP art. She then continued to create two award-winning art portfolios this year, adding to her 8 accumulated Scholastic Art Awards. She has made a name for herself here at Keene High School with a 4.493 GPA. All while maintaining an active extracurricular work schedule. She has been a member of the National Honor Society, the National Art Honor Society, Student Council, French Club, Rotary Interact Club, and Amplitude. She has been a horseback saddle seat equitation competitor, a horseback hunter jumper, and a Rick's ice cream server cashier. Tori has also built her leadership skills as the president of the National Art Honor Society, French Club, and Students for Hope. Additionally, she has held the positions of secretary and treasurer for the French Club and the Rotary Interact Club. Tori has instrumentally been involved with fundraising for the National Art Honor Society, National Honor Society, Rotary Interact Club, and Students for Hope. Her plan moving forward is to truly study the environment, environmental science, and hopefully a little art too. That's begging, right? At Dartmouth College this fall. Adding to this very impressive resume, she has a truly unique name, Astoria Fox. In fact, one of her best friends, Fiona, another unique name, shared Tori's middle name with me when I was inquiring about more personal information to add to my speech. Fiona said, yeah, do you know Tori's middle name? I said, no, actually I don't. Fiona said, her middle name is Bauda. I said, really, Bauda? That's so unusual. Fiona said, B-O-U-T-A. She chuckled and said, Astoria about a fox. I finally caught on, and we had a good old laugh. And that is when it hit me. I have to use this, I said. I felt I need to introduce Astoria in a creative way, more than just sharing her resume. Since our initial connection has been through art, I really wanted to introduce her in a unique way. I became inspired by the idea of writing a story about a fox, Astoria Fox. So here it goes. A story about a fox. Once upon a time, there was a fox named Tori. Her beautiful fur was the hue of warm burnt sienna. She loved to jump over her lazy golden ochre dog named Xander. The two of them would trot around together with delight, as foxes often do. Do you know the foxtrot? Tori and Xander joyously frolicked amongst all of Earth's creatures. Herds of horses would run by their side, often offering them a thrilling ride. Grateful for their time together, Tori and Xander would bestow wildflower seeds upon the Valley of Keene for all the kindred spirits to enjoy. The valley was soon filled with Tori's love. Colors of alizarin, halsa, cerulean, vermilion shimmered in the glistening sunlight. She surely was clever in how she composed those flower arrangements. People came far and wide to see her mesmerizing creations. Her work was met with such delight, Tori was honored with draping silver and gold medals. At the end of their days, Tori and Xander would make and eat freshly baked French pastries and ice cream. And when the table was cleared and the sun went down, Tori would transform. Wearing leather and lace, she and Xander would dance while the metal guitar would grind. Crazy like a fox, Tori would invite people to bang their heads to the screaming, squealing, beat-pounding music. Tori's fur would turn silver with each head nod, and everyone would cheer at her magnificent transformation. Those were wonderful times in the Valley of Keene for all. But there came a day when Tori needed to go. Xander stayed behind to care for the valley, for he knew Tori was eager to spread her magic throughout distant lands. Her next journey led her to the hamlet named Dartmouth, where only time would tell the impact she would have. But one thing was known. Her sly, charming ways would win the hearts of all who would cross her path. In my fox research, I learned that Native American, Eastern, Irish, and fox symbolism teaches us to grow with our environment. Create the future you desire fearlessly and with confidence. Just as a fox lives in harmony with itself, you too need to accept yourself wholeheartedly the way you are. Then your life will fall into perfect harmony too. Well wishes to the class of 2022. Now please help me congratulate the amazingly self-motivated, creative, artistic, kind, sly, quick-witted Miss Astoria Margaret Bauta Fox.
Okay. Oh, okay, I'm gonna try not to cry. Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for being here today to celebrate with the class of 2022. My name is Astoria Margaret Fox, and I am delighted to have this opportunity to speak to you all. As I'm sure many of you can agree, these past 4 years were full of unexpected events. While COVID played a huge role in all of our lives, and specifically our high school experiences, we also encountered individual challenges throughout the years. Personally, I thought that I would have it all figured out by the time I graduated. I thought I would have answers for questions like, what are you majoring in? And what career are you hoping to pursue? But here I am, standing in front of my entire class on the day of graduation, and I don't know how to answer either of these questions. And I'm sure we all know people or have friends who have always known what they wanted to be when they were grown up. Someone who knew they wanted to be a nurse since they were in elementary school, because they have always felt drawn to that career path. Or perhaps someone who is determined to be an FBI agent after watching a few too many episodes of Criminal Minds. We've all been there. I, on the other hand, am not one of these people. Although, for a few months in sophomore year, I was convinced that I was going to open up my own pastry shop. Hard to believe, but unfortunately, this dream was shattered once I found out that I would have to wake up at 3 a.m. every morning. As I'm sure many of you can agree, I am not a morning person. So that brings us back to square one. I still don't know what I want to do with my life. But you know what I have realized during these past 4 years? That not knowing what I want to do is really a blessing in disguise. It has allowed me to explore a wide range of classes at Keene High School and meet people that I otherwise never would have interacted with. I've discovered passions for art and environmental science that I otherwise never would have known. It will continue to benefit me by allowing me to take a variety of courses at college in the fall and take advantage of every opportunity that is thrown at me, as random as it may seem, because it just might lead to something that I love, or at least help me learn a little bit more about myself. And I encourage everyone here to take chances and try new things, even if you are dead set on what you want to do, because you may discover a new passion of yours. I am so excited to see what lies ahead for everyone here, and I am shocked that our time is coming to a close. I would like to thank my family and friends for supporting me throughout the last 4 years, and I also want to thank the faculty at Keene High School who have helped me realize my potential and become the student that I am today. Especially Mrs. Perry, who has always had her door open and never hesitated to lend a helping hand when I needed it the most. I will be forever grateful for having you as my teacher and friend. I hope all of you are just as excited as I am to graduate and step into the next chapter of our lives, whatever it may be. I wish you all the best, and although it has been said a million times by this point, congratulations to the class of 2022.
Thank you, Mrs. Perry, and congratulations, Tori. We all wish you the best. The band will now perform selections from How to Train Your Dragon under the direction of Mr. Richard Clark.
Thank you.
At this time, I would like to introduce our class advisors, Mrs. Tracy Johnston and Mr. Bill Hope. We would like to thank you for everything you did for the class of 2022.
Hi. Dr. Gallagher, Superintendent Malley, members of the school board, parents, guardians, family members, and invited guests, we now present the class of 2022. We'd also like to take a moment and recognize the Green and Gold House Office Administrative Assistants, Mrs. Melinda Mindy Hill, and Mrs. Jane Rokes. As well as the former Blue House Office Administrative Assistant, Mrs. Virginia Soma. And thank you so much for all of your efforts and all you do for the students every single day, year after year, and the connection you have with each one of these students. And we can't thank you enough.
We love you!
And these wonderful women will be calling off the graduates' names.
Elizabeth Michelle Stanish. Astoria Margaret Fox. Isabella Elizabeth Georges. Haley Marie Burnham. Sophia Marie Guardiano. Mia Elizabeth Brown. Aries Picardo Hunt. Michaela Marie Brooker. Rebecca Elaine Brown. Timothy Albert Lee. Eli Michael Echeverria. Rafael Antonio Sierra III. Owen Michael Avalotis. Olivia Grace Aldefer. Shay Rhiannon Amont. Trevor Timothy Amadon. Madeline Her Apple. Naranjana Thurgam, Archnaraj Indamethi. Jessica Sky Ogg. Casey Lee Babcock. Angelo Nicole Baker. Eliza Florence Bellaro. Karen Ryan Reed Barnard. Sophia Elaine Bates. Catherine Marion Bauer. Tyler Mark Beauchesne. Brady Mark Belden. Drew Aiden Bellevaux. Ian Henry Bergeron. Nina Lee Bills. Kaylee McKenzie Bernie. Kayla McKenzie Bernie. Liam Walker Blair. Ella Nancy Bogdanoff. Abigail Michael Bohannon. Annalise Jean Marlene Belusky. Zachary Neal West Barassa. Isabel Ann Bradford. Lily Joyce Brown. Sharanya Budakoti. Regan James Buffum. Megan Elizabeth Bunce. Jonathan Robert Thomas Burby. Emma Marie Burr. Jay Jameson Butler Jr. Raven Josephine Butler. Dominic Michael Carbonero. Cheyenne Marie Cardinal. Maya Corinne Carey. William Henry Carlisle. Liam Paul Carney. Anthony Michael Castro. Lacey Jane Champney. Brianna Lynn Clay. Brendan Robert Cloutier. Andrew John Colbert. Zachary Brian Call. John Ryan Comerford. Erica May Conant. Allison Weck Cooper Ellis. Kelsey Jean Court. Jillian Rose Cody. Paige Lorraine Cody. Justine Gail Colborn. Tristan Dale Coronis. Cara Jeannie Corsi. Savannah Ann Coots. Mark Andrew Darcy. Shekiah Marguerite Damon. Samuel Alfred Davidson. Yes, Michaela Alexis Dawson. Devin James DeRosiers. Avery Renee Dobbins. Samuel Joseph Dodson. Haley Louise Donais. Liam Pierce Dow. Elizabeth Rebecca Doyle. Max Walker Doyle. Alexandria Jada Drosheen. Drosheen. Darian Michael Drosheen. Ryan Edward Duggan. Lucian Alexander Dunham. Mary Alice Lee Dyer. Tristan James Eckert. Elliot Brown Etzweiler. Lauren Marie Fabus. Aiden Delaney Fouth. Nicholas Stephen Filimonoff. Tyler Joseph Finch. Elijah Trinity Fisher. Amanda Rose Fisk. Fiona Grace Fitzpatrick. Peyton Elizabeth Fitzpatrick. Angie Diane Ford Callahan. Jason Thomas Foster. Kyle Anderson Foster. Megan Ann Frazier. Maya Davia Frazier. Jonas James French. Jonah Josiah Frost.
Sophia Taylor Garland. Justin John Guerin. Justice Aaron Gazaway. Liam Michael Glodgett. Madeline Hazel Goldberg. Bella Gianna Goodell. Hayden Scott Gurley. Grace Nicole Green. Emma Rose Amelia Greenwood. Carmen Michelle Gregory. Keller Drew Grissom. Gavin Michael Gruber. Jack Rowan Hammonds. Alex William Hanninen. Natalie Rachel Hansen. Charlotte May Ann Harden. Maisie Lynn Haskins Tardif. Alexis Lee Hayes. Elijah Richard Hayes. Finnegan Micah Hayes. Hayden Isaiah Heath. Alexandra Maeve Hebert. Anna Michelle Hannigan. Julia May Hicks. Jonathan Peter Hills. Elizabeth Catherine Hines. Landon Matthew Henricks. Rebecca Catherine Holland. Samuel Rowan Holmes. Jennifer Caitlin Hummel. Nathan Michael Hope. Sylvia Veronica Hope. Ariana Nicole Hopewell. Jacob Adam Hutchins. Xavier Jonathan Hutchins. Saida Rodriguez. Ryan Christopher Jackson. Linda Jane James. Kevin Binney John. Sawyer Gage Johnson. Connor Robert Johnston. Kanan Marie Kalki. Kanan Mackenzie Kalki. Madigan Emily Keating. Matthew Christopher Keller. Brian Lepinid Kerber. Sharik Khan. Noah David Kinara. Torin Michael Kindop. McKenna Benet Jacques Klein. Emmanuel Koenig. Noah John Kress. Alexandra Nicole Krudelhalowa. Amber Patricia May Ray Lehendro. Matthew Robert Lambert. Matthew Roger Lambert. Jaheim Jamal Lancaster. Eliana Anathasha Lanou. Brant Ryan LaPointe. Alyssa Catherine Lehman. Gosmaz Laristi. Garrett Sawyer Lewis. Brennan Elijah Lilly. Calvin Jackson Lorty. Cameron Ann Lovejoy. Daniel Michael Luciani. Brianna Elizabeth Lucier. Ava Elizabeth Lucius. Jacob George Lugo. Quentin James Lyons. Nicholas Gregory Maiella. Riley Elizabeth Major. Stephen Joshua Marquez. Kelsey Rebecca Marshall. Shelley Mae Martell. Abigail Frances Martin. Abigail Rose Martin. Violet Ruby Masterson. William Lawrence May. Brody Austin McConnell. Wyatt Calvin McDonald. Gage Michael McGurk. Natalie Sage McKean. Kira Lane McLaughlin. Hannah Jane McPartlin. Lillian Eva McRae. Sydney Amber Merced. Joshua Stephen Mary. Noah John Michaud. Philbert Daniel Miffick. Jacob Riley Mignault. Braden Everett Milano. Hannah Lynn Miller Latko. Eliza Lee Mitchell. Rowan Christopher Moore. Dakota Moreau Owen. Austin Lee Morris. Riley Thomas Morse. Andacho Thomas Moosen. Jake Thomas Mueller. Samuel Adam Murray.
Garrett Thomas Nichols. Kieran Jack Norman. Robert Curtis Nowell. Emma Grace Nuzzo. Ian Xavier Wu. Gabriel Benjamin Page. Aiden Townley Paiu. Rebecca Jean Parks. Alexander Davison Payne. Tanner Slayton Payne. Matthew Kenneth Pete. Ava Elizabeth Pelkey. Owen Douglas Pelkey. Justin Allen Para. Sarah Noelle Perrin. Emily Aileen Peschel. Daniel Robert Petit. Harley Ruth Phillipson. Elijah Edward Bifford. Abigail Louise Pride. Nina Mary Preby. Marie Alice Proc. Ian Ellis Raffensberger. Molly Kathleen Raffensberger. Caden Joseph Raffiani. Margaret Ann Ramsey. Emma Catherine Randall. Maria Ann Ranta. Liam Patrick Redfield. Trinity Grace Reed Bonaparte. Jacqueline Jasmine Riqueno Amaya. Eli Gal Richardson. Be Lynn Rigg. Nicole Rodriguez. Jared Blake Brooks. Marcus Hunter Rokes. Marshall Stephen Roof. Caitlin Lee Rourke. Trent Ryan Russell. Aditi Jahan Saleh. Miranda May Salima. Olivia Ann Salima. Harrison Charles Salisbury. Riley Catherine Salisbury. Tabitha Rose Sanders. Jacob Hunter Sargent. Savannah Rose Scannell. Emma Ann Schmidl-Gagney. Jared David Schmidt. Juliana Rose Serpico. Jessica J. Shapiro. Hannah Rose Shepherd. Eliza Penelope Shepherd. Sean Michael Simeon. Lucas Aaron Seipler. Joshua Neil Vincent Sleeper. Ryan Kenneth Smart. Cassandra Ruth Smith. Summer Sky Smith. Colum Tamba Somme. Peyton Thomas Stand. Grace Valencia Stenickmas. Daniel Harley Starkey. Phaedra Yale Stemp. Marissa Lee Stetson. Claire Almond Stroshine. Evan William Tarver. Anna Lee Therese Taylor. Quinn Bevan Thatcher. Mason Michael Thibodeau. Owen Kenneth Thibodeau. Greta Roselle Thurmond. Nicholas Jeffrey Tondries. Warren James Tucker.
Warren.
Brian Michael Valenti. Ava Elizabeth Bitters. Preston Michael Wazin. Sarah Joy Walker. Madison Elizabeth Ahern Wallace. Tucker Michael Wallace. Keaton Edward Walsh. Kendra Mary Walter. Jasmine Warner DeMond. Macy Parker Weber. Kaya White Brooks. Isaiah Abdul Malik Whitney. Wyatt John Whitney. Alice Gail Whittemore. Gracie Marion Wilkes. Kaylin Jean Willette. Serena Aileen Willette. Dylan G. Wilson. Quinton Douglas Wilson. Maximilian Russell Wixon. Megan Elizabeth Littlelow. Ethan Skyler Yenger.
At this time, I would like to ask the class of 2022 Treasurer Sophia Guardiano to come forward and present the class gift.
Good evening. My name is Sophia Guardiano, and I have had the privilege of being the treasurer for the class of 2022. I'm very excited to be presenting the class gift to you all tonight. We are proud to be gifting the future generations of Keene High School with new furniture for the courtyard. We purchased both rocking Adirondack chairs and side tables that are made from 100% recycled materials and were also made in the U.S. The courtyard is a space that many Keene High Schoolers utilize to study, work on art projects, eat lunch, and hang out with friends. We hope that this gift allows the courtyard to continue to be a special and memorable spot for years to come. Thank you and congratulations.
Graduates, please stand. Superintendent Millay, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Keene High School, I present to you the class of 2022. As the principal of Keene High School, I certify that each student standing here before you tonight has met all of the requirements, duties, and obligations established by the New Hampshire Department of Education and the Keene School Board.
Principal Gallagher, through the authority vested in me as the superintendent of schools, as prescribed by statute in the state of New Hampshire and the policies of the Keene School District, I accept your certification and hereby declare the blackbirds in front of us graduates of Keene High School.
I'm pretty sure your tassels are still on the right. Okay. Graduates, now all of you ceremoniously may turn your tassels from the right side to the left side. This signifies the success. Congratulations to the class of 2022. Save your tassels if you're tossing. Distinguished members on the stage and guests, I'd like to thank everybody for being here this evening. I'd like to ask the marshals to stand. The recessional will be performed by Keene High School Band under the direction of Mr. Richard Clark. We're going to return the next tradition. Our faculty will march out first, aligning the cone lane so that you can greet the graduates. Mr. Clark, whenever you're ready, the faculty will go out first. Guest adults on the stage, if you want to join, you can go down too.
I'm
Kelsey?
No,
you need a video.
They had a drive-through graduation, so.